now let's welcome your host, Henry Kelly.
Thank you very much indeed. Welcome again to Going for Gold, our international European television quiz programme. Now, if you've been following the programme, I hope you have, I hope you've been enjoying it. We have been. You'll know then that already into our semi-finals for later in the series. Have a look at the leaderboard there. See who's there already. We've Scotland, England, Sweden, Austria, Denmark, and then last week they were all joined by Northern Ireland. So no country in Europe has yet managed to get two people through to the semi-finals. Well, if they do get through to those semi-finals and eventually to the final, they'll get the title and they'll win this.
The series winner will fly to Seoul in Korea and spend 2 weeks discovering this fascinating country, enjoying the delights, sights and atmosphere of Southeast Asia's unique culture. An experience to remember. And you'll be there as athletes from all over the world strive to win gold. Accommodation, all meals and tickets to final events and the fabulous closing ceremony are included. A great prize for the series winner of Going for Gold.
Yes, a really great prize for the series winner of Going for Gold. Well, you know by now that at the start of every show, we play an elimination round. We have seven contestants at the start of every week's shows, and four of you today will go through to the first round proper. So, hands on the buzzers, contestants, here we go. Who am I? I was born in Ithaca, New York in 1921 and grew up in various southern communities. I served in the US Coast Guard from 19... Wales.
John F. Kennedy.
Is not the correct answer, Wales. The rest of the question for the rest of the contestants. I began to write articles and short stories during that period. Norway.
Norman Mailer.
Norman Mailer is not correct. The rest of the question for the... Finland.
Alex Haley.
Alex Haley is correct. Well done. You're in the first round. Well done indeed. Right, so we've our first person through to the first round proper today. Hands on the buzzers, here we go again. Who am I? I was born in England in the 1940s. I teamed up with two guitar players to form a rock and roll band. We find England.
Eric Clapton.
Is not the correct answer, England. Rest of the question for the rest of the contestants. We finally broke through in 1962 at a marquee performance, and I soon my lead singer. Netherlands.
The Beatles.
Is not the correct answer. The rest of the question for the rest of the contestants. My lead singing on hits like Satisfaction made my group Scotland.
The Rolling Stones.
Is not the correct answer. Germany.
Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger was the Rolling Stone we wanted. Hard luck to Scotland there. She had the group, but not the exact person. So, from the five of you, we need two more. Hands on your buzzers again. What is my name? I'm a major church in England and one of my country's greatest treasures. Many famous men and women are buried here, and I have been since the Netherlands.
Westminster Abbey.
Is absolutely correct, Netherlands, and you're in the first round. So, we've got three contestants. We need just one more from England, Norway, Wales and Scotland for today's first round. Hands on the buzzers. Who am I? I was born in 1833 and died in 1896. As a young man, I worked in my father's factory attempting to make nitroglycerine a safe explosive to handle. I succeeded. Wales.
Nobel.
Nobel is correct, Wales. Very well done indeed. It means that just for today, we lose Norway, England and Scotland, but of course, we'll see them tomorrow. Okay, and that means that I have Finland, Germany, the Netherlands and Wales in the first round proper of Going for Gold. Come and join us. Right, and there they are, our four contestants into today's first round proper. Let's say hello to them properly. We welcome Helen Keatley from Wales. Helen, what part of Wales?
From Swansea.
From Swansea.
Yes.
Were you born and bred in Swansea?
No, actually born in Llanelli, but just moved a few miles up the road to
a
live.
A few miles up the road.
Yes.
Helen, any family?
Yes, I've got two boys.
How old are they?
One's 4 years old and one is 10 months old.
Well, the 10-month-old is probably fast asleep now, is he? But the four-year-old could deserve a wave, couldn't he, from Mum?
Yes. Hello, Gareth.
Hello, Gareth. Oh, that means he's going to be a rugby player.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely. Everyone from Wales calls Gareth his. Helen, good luck in today's show.
Thank you.
Now we welcome Jan Phillips from the Netherlands. Jan, welcome to you. I understand that you sing in a harmony group. Is that a barbershop quartet?
It's a chorus.
A proper chorus?
A proper chorus of about 70 people.
Really?
That's right.
Do you ever sing alone?
Sometimes, in the afterglow.
Sing us a quick song for Helen.
Heart of my heart, I love you.
Oh, Jan, beautiful, special for Helen from Wales. That was lovely, Jan. And of course, Helen will appreciate singing, coming as she does from Wales. Well, Mike Kimski, we welcome from Germany. Who, I understand, Mike, that you have a particular hobby. You collect stamps.
That's right.
Any particular country?
The country is Tokelau.
Is where, Mike?
Tokelau is a small Pacific dependency of New Zealand and consists of three atoll islands of 10 square kilometres size. Right. And they issue stamps.
Yes?
Yes.
And you've got them all?
I got them all, yes.
OK, Mike, well, today we hope you get all the answers on Going for Gold. It's lovely to have you with us. And from Finland, we welcome Pentti Laukma. Pentti, you're very welcome. I understand that this is not the first time you've been in a BBC studio. You used to work for?
I worked for the BBC External Services for 3 years in the early 70s.
Yes. Broadcasting or producing?
Yes, broadcasting.
Broadcasting. OK, Pentti, well, good luck in today's broadcast on Going for Gold. Thank you for coming. Well, contestants, this is the round where the questions are in categories. They'll be worth 1, 2, or 3 points, depending on which category you select. We'll begin with general knowledge for 1 point. I'm looking for 3 winners. The first 3 of you to get to 6 points goes through to our 4-in-a-row round. Are you ready? Hands on the buzzers. General knowledge for 1 point. In which continent is the state of Israel? Mike.
Middle East.
Is not the correct answer. Pentti.
Asia.
Asia is the answer I was looking for. Right. The Middle East was the area, the continent we looked for. Pentti, the category is wars. Select.
2, please.
A 2-point question on wars. Which civil war ended in 1865? Helen.
American.
The American is correct for 2 points. Helen, the category is animals. Select.
2.
A 2-point question on animals. What kind of creature is a Gila monster? Helen.
A fish.
Is not the correct answer. Mike.
It's an insect.
It is not an insect. The answer I wanted was either reptile or lizard. There is a difference. General knowledge for 1 point question. Of which race of people were the Cherokee, a famous tribe? Helen.
Red Indian.
Red Indian is correct. North American or Red Indians will do, Helen. The category is science. Helen, you're on 3 points. Select.
2.
A 2-point question. Heat rays is another name for which group of invisible rays? Helen.
Oh. Infrared.
You were too late, Helen. I'm sorry, but you did get the correct answer, so I can't give it to anybody else. I have to throw the question away and go back to general knowledge for 1 point. Of which school or university subject is calculus a branch? Mike.
Mathematics.
Mathematics is correct for 1 point. Mike, it gets you off the mark. The category is films. Select.
Poor, co-blimey.
Two. Two. Co-blimey? Is this a normal German expression, Mike?
No.
Just one you've picked up.
That's right.
2 points on films for everybody. Complete this Oscar-winning film title of 1952, The Greatest Show. Jan.
On Earth.
On Earth is correct for 2 points, Jan. Jan, your 2 points. The category is writers. Select.
One.
A 1-point question on writers. Life on the Mississippi is an autobiographical... Mike.
Mark Twain.
Mark Twain is the correct answer. Takes you to 2. The category is prisons. Select, Mike.
1.
1-point question on prisons. Which prison in West Berlin was used to house the Nazi war criminals? Jan.
Spandau.
Spandau is correct for 1 point, which takes you to 3. Jan, the category is sport. Select.
3.
3 on sport for Jan. It could be a win for either you or Helen. What nationality is the Grand Prix racing champion Nelson Piquet? Jan.
Brazilian.
Brazilian is correct. 6 points. You're in the next round. Jan goes through to the next round. So we're back to general knowledge for 1 point. Hands on the buzzers. Red, white, and which other colour makes up the national flag of Italy? Helen.
Green.
Green is correct. Takes you to 4 points, Helen. The category is birds. Select.
2.
For a win, which continent is the natural home of the bluebird? Mike.
Australia.
Is not the correct answer. Pentti.
America.
America is the correct answer. And that takes you to 3. Hard luck, Helen. You tried your buzzer there, but before I had said that the other answer was incorrect, you must wait. The category is words, Pentti. Select.
2, please.
A 2-point question. This could give Helen a win. What, starting with G, is the band worn around the leg? Mike.
A garment.
Is not the correct answer. Helen.
Garter.
A garter is correct. You tried it twice. You got it the second time. You're in the next round with 6 points. Oh, Helen got so excited there, she'd forgotten she got the six and was through to four in a row. Mike and Penty. Mike, you're on two. Penty, you're on three. General knowledge for 1 point. Which famous rock and roll singer had the second given name, Aaron or Aaron? Mike.
Elvis the Pelvis Presley.
Elvis the Pelvis Presley. Okay. That takes you to three, level with Penty. The category is musical instruments, Mike.
One.
A 1 point question. With the design and construction of which musical instrument is H.E. Steinway associated? Penty.
A piano.
The piano is correct. Takes you to four. The category, Penty, is mythology. Select.
Two, please.
For a win for you, but not for Mike. In mythology, Prometheus was punished for stealing and giving what to mankind? Finland.
Fire.
Fire is correct. You've got your 2 points. And you're in the next round. Oh, well done. Well, Mike.
Bad luck.
Mike from Germany, it's a shame to you to lose you, really. You've given us Corbline, you've given us Elvis the Pelvis Presley.
But Pelvis, yes.
Yes, you and me both will get it out. Mike, we'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for being with us today. Now, contestants, we're in four in a row. Here we go with your solo round. It's just you against the clock, and I'm looking for two winners to go through to today's final. Jan, you got into this round first, so here are your categories. Deserts, literature, the 50s, or scientific measurement. Jan, well, pick
maybe,
a category.
Maybe you have a bit dry-hearted, I go for deserts.
You go for deserts. Jan, will you come and join me here, please? Jan from the Netherlands, enjoying it so far?
So far, I enjoyed it very much.
Good. And you've been watching the programme, have you?
I have.
Good. And practicing a bit.
Practicing a bit. Listen, putting headphones over my head and excluding everybody so that I can concentrate on the broadcast.
Well done, Jan. Excellent. All right. Well, now's your chance. Your aim is to score four in a row. You will score 1 point for every correct answer you give me, but a wrong answer, as you know by now, I'm sure, takes you back down to zero. Let's put 40 seconds on the clock there for Jan from the Netherlands. You'll have all 40 to answer four in a row correctly. If not, your highest score will count. Jan, your time starts now. What is a mound or ridge of loose material formed by wind action in a desert known as?
I don't know.
It's a sand dune. Queen of the night, barrel, cushion and prickly pear are all types of what semi-arid plant?
Cactus.
Correct. On what continent is the Atacama Desert?
Asia.
No, South America. Name the mountain chain which forms the northernmost border of the Sahara Desert.
The Atlas.
Correct. Encompassing almost all of northern Africa, what is the largest desert in the world?
Sahara.
Correct. What is the name for a small, isolated, fertile area in a sandy desert that
oasis.
Has a local... Correct, oasis. Starting with B, name the Arab-speaking nomadic tribes of the Sahara.
Berbers.
Oh, you were just out of time. It actually wasn't Berbers. It was Bedouin, Jan. You didn't score four in a row, but you got up to three. Well played.
Thank you.
Helen, you have three from which to pick. Which one will you select?
Literature.
Literature. Helen, will you please come and join me here for your solo four in a row round on literature? We'll put 40 seconds on the clock for you now, and you'll have all 40 seconds to answer correctly four in a row or be credited with your highest score. Helen, from Wales, on literature, your time starts now. Tristan and Isolde were the principal characters of a famous medieval romance. Which of these two was the heroine?
Isolde.
Correct. Nana is the famous heroine of a novel by Emile who?
No. No.
It was Emile Zola. Which great science fiction novelist wrote The Time Machine and The Invisible Man?
H.G. Wells.
He did. From which country did the writer Natalia Ginzburg come?
Germany.
No, Italy. The heroine of Gustave Flaubert's novel was Madame who?
Fifi.
No, Bovary. Name the tragic heroine who was killed by her husband in Shakespeare's Othello.
Oh, Desdemona.
Correct. In the play Oedipus Rex by Sophocles, Oedipus outwittingly unmarried his mother. What was her name?
No, don't know.
Jocasta. Jean-Henri's play L'Alouette, or The Lark, centres around which French maiden? Oh, Helen, I'm sorry. You didn't get a chance to answer. You probably knew it was Joan of Arc. You didn't quite make it up to four. Today, Helen, you just scored 1 point. But thank you.
Thank you.
Penty, you are left with either the 50s or scientific measurement. Which will it be?
I'll try scientific measurement.
Scientific measurement. Penty, will you please come and join me? You have arrived already. You know the rules, Penty.
Yes, I do.
You need to score either four in a row, you're there. Three, you're there with Jan. Two, you're there. Even if you score just the one, Penty, you'll be in a tiebreaker with Helen. On scientific measurement, Penty, we've put the 40 seconds on the clock for you. Your time starts now. What is measured by a chronometer?
Time.
Correct. The decibel is a unit of measurement for what?
Loudness.
Correct. Sound. Correct. Name the type of meter used for counting individual particles of radiation.
I don't.
I need an answer. It was a Geiger counter.
Yes.
Named after a Swedish scientist, what is the term for the minute unit of length equal to 1/1000000th of a centimetre?
Ångström.
Correct. What is the basic measure of length in the international system of units?
Meter.
Is correct. 300,000 kilometers per second is the speed of what type of electromagnetic radiation in a vacuum?
Light.
Is correct. In the metric system, what is measured on the Kelvin scale? Just out of time, Penty. I suspect you knew that it was temperature or thermodynamic temperature. You didn't score four in a row, but you have scored three. Well played, sir. Which means, of course, that if we look at the score for today, we see that, alas, we have to say farewell until tomorrow for Helen, and she's taking it in good spirits. We'll see you tomorrow, Helen.
Thank you.
And which means that I am now able to ask Jan on 3 points and Penty on 3 points to come and join me in our head-to-head final as they go for gold. Come on, guys. Right, here we are. We're down to it. Today's final round, head-to-head between the Netherlands and Finland. Everybody by now knows how to play the game. You need 9 points to win. You've got control of the game, Jan, in a moment, if you like it, because you got first into this round. I can tell you that the first subject I'm going to ask you a question on is leaders. There's an extra clue for you watching at home. On the subject of leaders, Jan, will you play or pass?
I'll pass.
You'll pass. All right, you'll pass over to Penty on the subject of leaders. Penty, who used to work for BBC World Service in his native Finland. Maybe leaders is a subject for you, is it, Penty?
Maybe.
Maybe. Well, you've got it whether it is or not now, Penty, and this is the final for today. And on leaders, your time starts now. I was born in 1926. In 1956, I was elected to the French National Assembly, and from 1962 to 66 was Minister of Finance, a post I again held from 1969 to 1974 under President Pompidou. After his death, I became the third president of the Fifth Republic, a post by Penty.
Giscard d'Estaing.
Giscard d'Estaing is the correct answer. Answered in the two zone, which means, of course, Jan, that you are now playing catch-up. The subject is the United States of America. There's a clue for you watching at home. On the USA, Jan, will you play or pass? You will play on the United States of America. Your time starts now. I was born in Massachusetts in 1924. I served as a naval pilot during the Second World War, winning a Distinguished Flying Cross for heroism. From 1966 to 1970, I served as a U.S. congressman and later was U.S. ambassador to the United Nations. I directed the CIA in 1976 and 77. In May 1980, I was nominated for the post of vice president at Ronald Reagan's request, and on his election... Well, we won't let them know that you've never heard of George Bush.
Yeah, now I know.
All right.
It's too late.
Which means, Jan, that you are playing catch-up. The subject is animals. There's a clue for you watching at home. On animals, Jan, will you play or pass?
Yes, I'll play.
You'll play on animals. Your time starts now. I am said to be one of the most intelligent of all animals. I normally lead a peaceful life, travelling in groups of 2 to 10 through the rainforest that cover Central Africa. We never spend more than one night in the same place. Jan?
Monkeys?
Is not the correct answer, Jan, I'm afraid. Penty, you have control of the game, and time continues now. While I look fierce with my shiny black face, pointed teeth, and huge body, I rarely harm a human being. I am the largest of the great apes. I am?
Gorilla.
A gorilla, Jan, is correct. Answered in the two zone. You got there just in time, which means the scores are now level. But Jan, you got into this round first. The offer is yours. The subject is 20th century history. There's a clue for you watching at home. Play or pass, Jan?
I'll play.
You will play on 20th century history. Your time starts now. I was born in Württemberg in 1891 and died in 1944. I served as an infantry officer, and in 1940 I took command of a panzer division in France. The following year I was sent to the aid of the almost defeated Italian army in Libya, and my many battle successes there won me the nickname Jan.
Rommel.
Rommel is the correct answer, Jan, in the two zone. Which means, Jan, that you've gone to four and you have to play catch-up, Penty. The subject is the arts. There's a clue for you watching at home. Penty, will you take the arts?
I'll try to play.
You will try to play. All right, your time on the arts starts now. I am an artisan, born in Paris in 1840. Indifference and misunderstanding greeted the first exhibits of my works, and it wasn't till 1880 that I was accepted as the greatest sculptor of the period. I admired Michelangelo and like him, Jan.
Rodin.
Rodin is the correct answer. In the three zone. Which means that you've gone to 7, Jan. It means that for you, Penty, you're playing catch-up yet again. The subject is music. There's a clue for you watching at home. On music, Penty, player pass.
I play.
You will play on music. And your time starts now. I am a composer, conductor and pianist born in 1918. I composed the Symphony Jeremiah, Chichester Psalms and jazz rhythms such as In the Age of Anxiety. I also composed a work called Mass. But I am probably best known for the scores of such musicals as On the Town, Wonderful Town and Penty.
Bernstein
is the correct answer. In the two zone brings you to 4, which means, Penty, that you are now playing catch up. The subject is geography. Here's a clue for you watching at home on geography, Penty.
I'll play.
Yes, I would have thought so, that somebody who worked in a world service and comes from Finland would play on geography. But he is only 2 points away from being today's winner, Penty. So your time on geography starts now. What is my name? In spite of my name, I am really a freshwater lake. The ruins of the ancient city. Penty.
Dead Sea.
The Dead Sea is not the correct answer, which means that, Jan, you have control of the game on 7 points, and your time continues now. The ruins of the ancient city Capernaum can be seen on my shores, and so too can the city, Jan.
The Lake of Galilee.
The Lake of Galilee in the trees over the meteor, today's winner. Jan, well played indeed, sir. Not only are you in the heat final later on this week, you've got this lovely memento of your achievement, which is exclusive to winning contestants on Going for Gold, and we'll see you later this week. Jan, well played, sir. Oh, yes. Oh, Penty, commiserations, Penty. But don't worry, of course, we'll see you tomorrow on Going for Gold. And we hope, of course, that after a wonderful game and a day like today, you'll be all watching Going for Gold. We'll see you then. Bye-bye. Congratulations, Jan. Terrific game. Well played, chaps. Very, very well played.